Thousands of local restaurants still struggling to bounce back from the pandemic, and funding from the American Rescue Plan has dried up, leaving many businesses scrambling once again. Channel 3 Waterbury Bureau Chief Dennis Valera is live in Hartford. And Dennis, I have to imagine the goal here is really to get more funding.
Yeah, Aaron, the Restaurant Revitalization Fund, it helped more than 1,300 restaurants here in the state, but it left another 2,000 in need. Some dealing with the same issues that continue to worsen as things seem relatively normal on the surface.
Once the state fully reopened, many flocked to restaurants, giving the impression these businesses were on the road to full recovery.
We're kind of one arm tied behind our backs.
But they're still struggling. At a roundtable with Congressman Richard Blumenthal, several restaurant owners made their case why more federal funding needs to be set aside for the Restaurant Revitalization Fund. The $28.6 billion program only helped 101,000 eateries and caterers nationwide. In Connecticut, more than 2,000 eligible businesses were not able to get a slice of the pie, a tough pill to swallow as they continue to deal with issues like low staffing.
We just want to kind of reach out to people and say, we're here, we're open, we appreciate your support. But just bear with us for a little while and be patient because we're having staffing problems.
The owners say more funding is needed just to level the playing field. Jonathan Jennings of Connecticut Wedding Group says he lost an employee to a competitor who got RRF funds.
The ones who have been funded now have the resources to hire the staff, to deal with the increase in food costs, to pay higher wages, to repair and maintain their facilities.
Blumenthal made a promise he'd get his colleagues to allocate more funds.
I think Congress has no business taking recess unless we replenish the restaurant revitalization program. We have no business leaving town without doing infrastructure.
Low staffing at food suppliers is also starting to affect restaurants. Later at 6, we'll hear how restaurants have had to adapt yet again, some even changing their menu. Live here in Hartford, Dennis Valera, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.